Welcome to PCB e-classes. This is the first lecture on the basic electrical engineering. Now, let's get started. Before starting the basic electrical engineering subject, we should be aware of what is the basic aim of this subject. Now, the basic aim is to transfer the electrical energy from one point to the another. So, we'll start with the basic aim. What is the basic aim? To transfer electrical energy from one point to another. In order to transfer and electrical energy from one point to the another, what are the things we require? We require some combination of the elements, right? So, next point is that how to transfer. We require an interconnection of elements to transfer the energy, that is the electrical energy, from one point to another. Right? So, this interconnection of elements is said to be electric circuit. That means what? It means that in order to transfer the electrical energy from one point to the another, we need the help of the electric circuit. What is that electric circuit? Interconnection of elements which is said to the electric circuit. Now we will see later on what are the elements which we are using for transferring the electric energy from one point to the another. Those are the different things. Now, so what is the basic aim to transfer electrical energy? And for transferring the electrical energy, we require electric circuit. So, let us see what is charge. Hope so everyone knows about it, but we'll see the charge in a very brief manner. Now, it's denoted as Q, or we can take this one as capital Q. Right? Its unit taken as coulomb, indicated by C. Coulomb. Its unit is coulomb. These are the notations what we are using it. Right? Now let us see what is that. It is an electric property of an atom which exerts an attractive
और रिपल्सिव फोर्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन टाइप ऑफ इट, राइट? चार्ज इज दिस वन, इट्स एन इलेक्ट्रिकल प्रॉपर्टी. नाउ we'll see how many types of charge are there. Now let us see how many types of charge are there. Now as I am saying that charge is a property of an atom, so let us move to the atomic structure. Now if I'll go for the atomic structure, generally we have a nucleus. Around this nucleus some energy cells will be there, some energy cells will be there, right? This is our nucleus. In this energy cells, some charged particles will be there. Those are said to be electrons, that is negatively charged particles. Fine. Next, coming to the nucleus. What does this nucleus contain? We already know about it. This nucleus consisting of two things. One is protons, which are positively charged particle, whereas another is neutrons, which are neutrally charged, zero. Neutrally charged particles, neutrally charged particles. But if you can remember, in the energy cell the electrons can revolve, right? So it will be revolving around the nucleus. Around this nucleus on the energy cell the electrons can revolve. That means which is movable in nature? Electrons are movable in nature. Can we say the protons are movable in nature? Never. They are inside the nucleus. That means they cannot come out of the nucleus and they are immovable in nature. So protons cannot move, whereas electrons can move, which means negative charge always moves, whereas positive charge doesn't move. Then how we are saying it is a positive charge or the negative charge? Which can move here? Electrons can move, protons cannot move, right? So when I am saying that positive charge, when I am saying positive charge of an atom, positive charge means what? If I am saying that it is positively charged, what does it mean? And if I am saying it is negatively charged, what does it mean? The meaning is different. Here we are not saying the positive means the protons are moving, right? What we will see, the electron, we will be defining the positive charge and the negative charge with respect to the flow of electrons or electrons, right? So if it is having deficit of electrons, then that will be said as positive charge. If it is negative, that means what? Excess of electrons, which will be having the more electrons, that will be said as negatively charged. Which will be having deficit, less electrons, then that will be said as positively charged. In this way, as per electric charge concerned, are of two types. One is positive charge, another is negative charge. Whereas we are not least bothered about the neutrons because those are the neutrally charged. Fine. So charge are of two types. One is positively charged. Another is negatively charged. Clear? Yep, this is all about the charge. Now we'll go little bit deeper or something very important regarding this electrons and the protons. Fine? If I'm saying the electrons are moving, right? How much charge is contained? That also we should know it. So, very very important, we should know about it. One electron equals to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Already I have said it, coulomb is a unit of charge, right? So one electron equals to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, right? Similarly, for one proton also, it is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Proton is positive, right? So it will be written as positive. Electron is negative. That means it should be written as minus. Minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. And this will be 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Right? But generally we will take the magnitude or the modulus. So we will be taking it as the one charge particle equals to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Now we'll come for the first point. We are saying that electron is flowing, right? So if I'm saying that one electron equals to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, clear? That means if I find out for one coulomb how many electrons, then what will be the here? 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 electrons. Which means, if I transfer one coulomb charge, then we will be having 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons. Very very important. In order to transfer one coulomb charge, in one coulomb charge, how many electrons are traveling, transferred? 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons, which means coulomb is the larger unit of charge. Fine? Coulomb is considered to be the larger unit of charge because in one coulomb, how many electrons are traveling? 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons means it's a huge number. So charge cannot be said as a smaller unit, rather it will be said as a larger unit of the charge. Coulomb can be said as the larger unit of the charge. Fine? So this is about the first one. That the basic first one, that is a charge. Now let us move to the current. What is current? We all know about the current. So let us see first one. How it is denoted? It's denoted as or fine, I. Its unit is ampere, denoted as A. Right? Let us move to the definition. How it is defined? Very simple. Flow of electrons. If there is flow of electrons, that means it is a current which is traveling. We will be saying the flow of electrons or rate of flow of charge. Which charge is movable? Electrons, the same thing. Rate of flow of charge is known as current. Right? So, can I write down this one as from the definition, can I formulate it? Yes, I can formulate it. What will be the formula? I equals to rate of flow of charge dq by dt. What is this one? Charge. What is this one? Time. As what is the unit? Unit of charge? Coulomb. Unit of time? Second. So what is the unit of the current? Another unit we are getting it. Unit of current can be written as Coulomb per second. Otherwise known as ampere. Both are same. Coulomb per second is otherwise known as ampere. Now, what is the major thing we have to know about the current? Very, very important. Direction. Direction of current. What is the direction of the current? Direction of current is exactly opposite to the flow of electrons. Okay, what is it? It's exactly opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. What I mean is, if I am taking the direction of flow of electrons is this one, then the current direction will be exactly opposite. This will be my current direction. Fine? Very, very important. You have to take it as a note. Very, very important. Whatever the flow of electrons will be there, the direction of the flow of electrons, its opposite direction will be the current. Fine? This is the second one what we have discussed. Let us move to the third one. That is potential or voltage. What is potential? In a layman language, we are saying that you have that much potential to run a 100 meter race. You have that potential to jump from one point to the another point. Right? You have the potential to do certain work. Right? So, how the potential is defined? Potential is defined as to move a particle, what is the work done? We are doing it. That is said to the potential. Another way, if you define it properly, as per the physics, what it says, as we are dealing with a charged particle, so what it says, potential is defined as the work done to move a unit charge from infinite to a point. It is a work done to move a unit charge from infinite to a point. Fine? In other way, we can say that the work done to move a charge particle, unit charge particle, from one point to the another. Fine? This is what the definition says. So let us define it first. Before definition, as we have done in the current as the charge, current and the charge, we will see the voltage part denoted as V or V. Fine? Next, its unit. Volt definition. How we are defining? We are defining as it is a work done to bring or move a unit charge from infinite to a point. Another definition, what we are defining? It's the work done or energy utilized to bring an unit charge from one point to another. Same, infinite is a point. We are saying that as a point, one point to the another. Same definition. Sometimes it is defined mathematically in a different way. How it is defined? It's also defined as change in energy per unit charge. What does it mean? That means I can formulate it now. How can I formulate? I can say that voltage equals to d energy or the work done, dw by dq. What is this one? Work done or energy. Work done or energy. And what is this one? Charge. So, what is the unit of it? Work done, unit. Joules. What is the unit of charge? Coulomb. So, what is the unit of voltage now? The unit of voltage, another unit we got it, unit of voltage is joules per coulomb, which is otherwise known as volt. This can be also a unit, very very important. This can be also a unit, that is joules per coulomb, otherwise known as volt. This is all about the potential. Now, a major confusion is there within the students. what is potential and what is potential difference. So let us discuss about it. This is a point I have taken. Let us take it's a point A. I want to find out the potential at that point. Potential at that point. So if I'm declaring that potential at this point is VA, then this will be said as a potential at point A. What is this one? Potential at point A. How you can define it? Now, how we are doing it? Generally, when we are finding out a potential at a point, we are finding out with respect to the ground. With respect to the ground. What is the ground potential generally? It's a zero. So we are taking the difference between them, a point and a ground. So what will be the difference? Potential difference. That is VA minus zero, which is equal to VA. What basically it is? Difference between the potential at A and the ground, whose ground potential is always zero. The potential difference is equals to VA minus zero, which is implying that VA. As it is the ground potential is zero, so this becomes potential at A. There is a very thin line difference. This is also a potential difference and also said to be the potential at a point A. So you have to make a point that potential is taken at a point. Fine. Now we will take the example of the potential difference. Let us take an example, right, for the potential difference. Let us take, it's a point A and another point as B. I'm saying that the potential at A, I'm taking as VA. What does it mean? Potential at A means, potential at A means the potential with respect to the ground. We say to the potential at A. Similarly for this one also, it is with respect to the ground. So the potential at A and B are taken as V and V. What will be its difference? That will be said as potential difference. So potential difference, if I am taking it, I will be writing down as V A B. Means what? A I am considering as higher potential and B I am considering as lower potential. So what will be this one? V A B will be V A minus V B, where V A is, that is, what is the condition? VA is greater than VB. I am assuming it. Fine. If I am writing down this one as VBA, means VB minus VA, that is, what is the condition? VB will be greater than VA. Which one is higher potential? B is the higher potential, I am assuming it. Whereas A is the lower potential, I am assuming it. Fine? Higher to the lower. So I am taking higher minus lower. Well, this is about the potential difference. Clear?
Now, in several exams, it creates a confusion with the notations given by the in the exam paper. Fine? So, if it is given in the exam paper, such as this is a voltage source. Plus minus point A, point B, and it is written as, the value is written as minus 3 volt. What to be done? Which one is higher potential? Whether VA is higher potential or VB is higher potential? How can you know it? Point to be noted, never judge the higher potential or lower potential from the value. Always assume from diagram. You will see which one is higher potential and which one is a lower potential. Let us see. Which part is given positive? Positive is given as A point, right? So, I am considering that potential at A is at higher potential. Potential at B, which is connected to the negative. So potential at B, VB, I am considering as lower potential. Now, what is the potential difference between them? VAB. Right? What is the potential difference? I am saying it, VA minus VB, what is the value you have given? Minus 3 volt. So it is minus 3. So this I can write down as VA minus VB equals to minus 3, which can be written as VB equals to VA plus 3. Can I write? What does this equation indicates? This equation indicates that VB is higher than the VA. What we have assumed? VA is higher potential. From where we have assumed? We have assumed from the diagram. From the notations what it is given, we have taken that one only as higher potential. But after calculation, what we are getting? VB is greater than VA. By how much? 3. That means, actually, VB is higher potential, VA is lower potential. So, which one is higher potential? This part is your lower potential, that is an A point. This part is your higher potential, that is the point B. Clear? So, in this way you have to find out the higher potential and the lower potential in the exam. Else, if this type of problem is there, there will be an error. While solving it, you will be getting a wrong answer, which will be the option number 1. Always. Fine. Let us move to the next one, that is power. How we are defining it? We will see now. But let us first, it's denoted
as P, denoted as P, unit as watts. If it is an SI unit, then it will be written as kilowatts, kilowatts, megawatts, gigawatts. Fine, it's a unit. Now let us come to the definition. What is power? Power is defined as the rate of work done, rate of work done. What will be its definition? Define rate of work done, right? So from this one, how can I define, or how can I formulate it? P equals to rate of work done means what? dW by dt. What is this one? Work done. What is this one? Time. So unit, unit of power can be, work done unit is joules, time unit is second. So joule per second, otherwise known as watt. This is the power. Fine. Now mathematically, how we are dealing with it? Mathematically, another formulation we will be getting into. As per the mathematical, electrically equations we will be getting. Mathematically, if power will be written as dW by dt, can I write down this one as dW by dq into dq by dt? Yes, I can write it mathematically. What is dW by dq? Voltage. What is dq by dt? Current. So P equals to V into I. So mathematically, how it is defined? Power is defined as product of voltage and current. Power can be defined as a product of the voltage and the current. Energy. As per the physics, we know about it. The ability of doing certain work is said to be the energy. Right? So it's defined as ability of doing certain work is said to be the energy. What is unit? I'll say it's unit. Joules. Fine? Its unit is joules. But this is as per the physics. Right? But as per the electrical, the electrical energy mathematically formulated as E equals to integral P dt. Fine. What is the unit of the P? We have already seen watt. What is the unit of the time? It's second or hour. Anything else? Fine. So the unit as per the formulation, the unit of electrical energy is watt hour, depending on the unit, that is, it may be kilowatt hour, megawatt hour, gigawatt hour. The energy is, the electrical energy unit will be the watt hour, and it is formulated as E equals to integral P dt. Fine, this is very important. This is all about the first lecture number 1, where we have dealt with the fundamentals of the electricity and different terminology. The rest we will see in the next lecture. Thank you.